All right. Hello, everybody out there. Welcome to the SEG Metrics Support Webinar. Today is Thursday, May 18th, 2023. Hey, if anybody can just throw in the chat that they can hear me, they can see me, everything sounds good, that'd be great. I'll be monitoring the chat. Awesome. Thanks, Laura. Laura says that she can see and hear me. Awesome. Thank you. Thank you. All right, we've got someone from Portland, Oregon, it looks like, Meg. Yeah, let me know where everyone's from. Just throw it in the chat. I always like to know who I'm talking to and where y'all are coming to me from. I'm Ian from the customer success team here at SEG Metrics. And just to kind of give you a brief introduction to myself, I've been with SEG Metrics about 3 years now, coming up on the 3 year. On the day-to-day, I generally help people with their setup, their configuration of SEG Metrics, getting them going, getting them started. And then the other part of my job is kind of doing these webinars and doing support live Q&As, working on the knowledge base, educational content, et cetera. Cool, so it looks like we have some folks from SoCal, Wisconsin, someone in Canada, Dallas. Hey Roxanne, how's it going? So I see actually a lot of familiar faces, names, I should say. I've seen some of your faces on calls before, so glad to be amongst good company here. But yeah, today we have an exciting webinar. We're going to be talking all about UTMs today and really unleashing the power of UTMs in SEG Metrics. So the great thing about UTMs is they're a great way to track your links, track your emails, track your social posts, and any other kind of marketing content that utilizes links. And UTMs, again, are a great way to really track that information. So if you're not super familiar with UTMs, that's okay. We're gonna kind of start at the beginning here and work our way up all the way into learning how to track them in SEG Metrics and the best setups, best type of reports to look at and whatnot when it comes to that. So let's kind of move forward. Just want to go over the webinar outline really quick with everyone. So today we're going to talk about just a quick overview and why they work great in SEG Metrics. Using the tracking links feature to build links and UTMs. So we have a handy feature built right in SEG Metrics that will allow you to build your links as well as your UTMs if you select to use that. Third, we're going to talk about UTM naming convention and best practices. So we're going to talk about why it's important to be concise and consistent with your naming conventions when it comes to UTMs. And then fourth, we're going to start talk about reporting on UTMs and SEG Metrics. So once we've got the UTMs running, sending out to our marketing base, how do we track those in SEG Metrics? And then lastly, we'll leave some time at the end for a quick Q&A. So if you want to kind of throw your questions in the chat while I'm going over this, feel free to, and then we'll go back over those at the end and kind of answer those questions here, okay? Cool, so let's dive right in. Let's see, okay, so quickly, I just wanna kind of go over a quick UTM overview. Now this is likely gonna be review for, you know, a lot of you, but if you're just getting started with SEG Metrics or you're kind of new to UTMs and not too sure what they are. Before I get going though, I want to drop a cool resource in the chat. Now this is a PDF that we came up with a couple years back. So I'm just going to drop that in the chat really quick. So feel free to open that up. I'm going to be kind of loosely basing the webinar structure off of this PDF as well. Okay. So lots of good information here, you know, save it to your tabs. Share it amongst your colleagues. And again, lots of good information and kind of breakdown of what UTMs are. So just to kind of get going here, UTM codes are snippets of text added to the end of a URL to help you track where website traffic comes from. Marketers can customize this text to match the web page this URL is linked on, allowing them to attribute the success of that campaign to specific pieces of content, you know, such as an email or social post that might be organic. UTMs are currently the industry standard for tracking marketing campaigns across tools and are understood by analytics platforms like Google Analytics, Mixpanel, SEG Metrics, and more. So these days, most analytics tools, marketing apps, marketing automation tools, and CRMs look for these parameters automatically, and SEG Metrics is one of those tools that does that. So yeah, so you know, a lot of folks are already using Google Analytics or something like Mixpanel, and if you're on this webinar, you're probably using Segmetrics. And like we mentioned, Segmetrics automatically looks for those standard UTMs. So that could be UTM source, UTM campaign, UTM term, UTM content, UTM medium. And if you have Google Analytics installed on your pages, landing pages, or any other content, that's what Google Analytics looks for, and is how they are able to show you those analytics on their interface as well. So keep in mind, Segmetrics utilizes those standard UTMs, those five standard UTMs, and we'll kind of go over those here in a second. But yeah, so I just wanted to give a quick example of what a URL with a UTM code looks like. So if we take this example here, essentially what we have is a URL, standard URL makeup, pointing to a specific landing page on our website. And then anything after this question mark is essentially those UTM codes that essentially tells the browser or any other tracking platform that you might have installed, such as Segmetrics or Google Analytics on your website, you know, a little more information about where this click came from and where that person who clicked the page found this link. So for instance, this could be a UTM campaign showing, you know, we're throwing a feature launch and UTM medium came from social. So that would indicate that we've linked this, that we've placed this link on a social platform. Maybe that's Facebook or Twitter or whatever that might be. And the UTM medium, or sorry, UTM source tells me that that specific link came from Facebook. Now, keep in mind, if you're posting on different social platforms, you can kind of change that out. So if you're posting on Twitter, you might do a UTM source equals Twitter, or UTM source equals Instagram, or wherever that other place might be, okay? So now if we were to take a look, and how does that look in the browser? So if we switch over and actually open up like a Google Chrome and navigate to that page, we'll see that we come to the landing page in question, or that the URL is pointing to, and anything after that URL page direction is going to be those UTMs. Now, this is what your tracking pixel, such as your Segmetrics tracking pixel, will pick up on that page load. Okay, so if you have your tracking pixel installed, Segmetrics automatically says, okay, we see some UTMs at the end of this link. Grab those, throw them in our database, and now they're, you know, once we get that email address of the person, we can then say, okay, well, this is the person that clicked that link, and therefore we can attach these UTMs back to an individual person. Now Google Analytics is a little bit different. They don't actually collect email addresses, right? So what they'll show you is a little bit different in terms of, you know, hey, X number of hits hit this web page with this, with these tracking, sorry, these UTM parameters. So that's kind of a big difference again in how Segmetrics and something like a Google Analytics tracks. Google Analytics a little bit more of a black box in terms of, you know, you don't know exactly who that click came from, whereas, you know, Segmetrics can tell you exactly who that click came from because we're connecting it to the CRM, pulling that email address and connecting that click back to that email address in our database, okay? So a lot of folks will like to use Google Analytics and Segmetrics kind of in tandem just to kind of get different viewpoints of that tracking. Cool. So that kind of takes care of that example. Now I want to go over, you know, how do you build out your UTMs? And really quick, I just want to kind of mention that we have a really great feature in Segmetrics that allows you to kind of take that into your own hands. Now, a lot of times, if you're using something like ActiveCampaign or Infusionsoft or Keep, as they're known now, or any other number of email marketing platforms that might already have an automatic UTM builder, you know, some folks opt to use that, which can make it really easy because they'll, you know, that platform will automatically append those UTMs to those email contents. However, if you're doing something like this organic social post, this could really come in handy. So essentially what we're gonna do is we're gonna go to tools, you might see on your left sidebar, and tracking links, that'll bring you to this page. Now to create a new tracking link, we'll just say new tracking link. And let's say we wanna call this like a spring sale or something like that. So I'm gonna call that my spring sale link. And let's say I just wanna go point to, I'm just gonna use our Segmetrics website as an example. All right, so that's going to be their main URL there. And if you have any other landing page directories, like, you know, blog or something like that, you'll want to put those there as well. But now here's where you can kind of, you know, build your UTMs here. All right, so quickly, if you're following along with the PDF, you'll see a little bit further down in the PDF, we kind of cover each specific UTM parameter here. So there's really five UTM parameters that you can utilize here. And those are the five that Segmetrics will automatically pull in and track, okay? And then what you can filter on in your reports. And these are going to be the five standards that things like Google Analytics or like Mixpanel or, you know, a number of other tracking platforms are going to utilize and track in their metrics, okay? So we're going to start with source here. So source, just to kind of go give you a brief overview of your source, you know, source-based URL parameter can tell you which website is sending you traffic. So if I were on Facebook, for example, and I saw an organic social post for like a sale coming up or a spring sale, you might be a coaching business. So it doesn't really matter what type of business you are, whether that's e-commerce, coaching, agency, trying to get more clients, doesn't really matter the business model that you're running. UTMs are going to be very universal to any type of business platform. Okay, so for instance, if I'm placing that link on Facebook, I'm going to use UTM source equals Facebook. Okay, so we have a number of built-in examples here. So I'm just going to select Facebook because that's where I'm going to be placing this link. If I were placing it on Twitter, I would use that or Instagram, or, you know, if I'm sending an email through ActiveCampaign, that might be my source as well. Now, of course, you can always type one in here, hit enter, and that will enter that into that source. But for the sake of this purpose, I'm going to say, I'm going to run an organic Facebook social post, and I want to know that anytime somebody clicks that, it's going to be Facebook. Now, medium, this type of tracking tag informs you of the medium that your track link is featured in. Okay, so again, Facebook is a social platform, so essentially what I'm going to do is I want to know that this came from a social platform. So I believe we don't have it yet. So we can just type in social. And that again tells me that it's coming from a social platform such as like Facebook or Instagram or, you know, Twitter or any other sort of social platform. Now keep in mind, if I was running an email, right, I might select email there. But for this purpose, again, I'm going to do social platform. All right, so campaign. Now, this is one of the more commonly used, and a lot of times, now keep in mind, you don't have to use all five of these on every single one of your links, right? So I'm just gonna give an example of all five, but you know, whatever's relevant to the current situation, you know, sometimes a content or term might not make sense, or a campaign. Generally, campaign is gonna be the most commonly used along with medium and source, just keep that in mind. So campaign-based tracking tags are groups group all the content from one campaign in your analytics. Names that allow you to easily identify product launches, promotional campaigns, individual emails or posts are all good. So for example, let's say, again, we're doing a spring sale 2023. I would probably put something like spring sale 2023. Something like that, maybe. Now keep in mind, you don't really want to use spaces in between your UTMs. And I'll kind of give you an example of what happens when, in fact, I think, let me show you here. All right, so if we were to use a space in between one of our UTM terms, keywords, essentially what would happen is they'd put a percent sign there. And so, you know, we'll, in Segmetrics, I'll give you an example coming up when we look at the reporting, but in Segmetrics we'll automatically parse that out and show you like a pretty version of that. But just keep that in mind, sometimes if you're using spaces, that the browser will automatically insert like a percent sign or some other symbol just to denote a space. So usually what I'll use is like a hyphen or an underscore will work as well, or what's known as camel casing, where you capitalize each first letter of each new word in there. So I'm just gonna use a hyphen for an example there. So that's gonna be my content, my campaign. Now let's move on to content and term. So content can be used to differentiate different ads or emails or different types of content, right? So let's say this is going to be like an organic social post or something like that. I might put organic just to let me know that, hey, this came from, it wasn't from an ad, it wasn't from an email, it wasn't from any other sort of content other than, okay, I created an organic social post and here's my organic post, okay? And term is gonna be a keyword-based tracking code, identifies the keywords that maybe you've either paid for, like let's say you're running a PPC ad or a PPC, like a banner ad or something with another third-party affiliate, or if you have multiple links in the same campaign. So let's say, for example, you're running like a drip sequence email campaign. This might be a good place to differentiate, you know, which email that link is from. So that might be like email one, et cetera. But for an organic social post, that might not be as relevant. But what I could do is maybe put, you know, if I'm keeping track of my posts in terms of, let's say I'm doing a staggered post launch or deployment each day, maybe I'm going to release a new organic social post or once a week or something like that. So I could say something like post one, and I can even get more specific, right? Like Facebook post one or something like that. So I'm going to save that link. And now we have that link saved and I can copy that to my clipboard. And now I can just go on over to Facebook, write out my content and my copy in the organic post. And anywhere I'm going to link to, I'll use this link, okay? And the cool thing about doing this in Segmetrics is that we'll track views, and we'll track other stats. And then within the reporting, we'll also track everything in terms of related to those UTMs. But again, if I were to just take this, go to my browser, throw that in there. Again, just going to our website. And now, again, our pixel will automatically pick up all of that information on that within those UTM terms and be able to report on the on that information with directly from you know, our reports or dashboards. So some cool ways to kind of up your tracking information. Again, keep in mind, not all five are required, but as much information as you use, and this is where it kind of comes down to being a little bit more concise and using good naming conventions here, all right? So when it comes to UTM naming conventions, you know, a couple rules to kind of play along with is, you know, be really specific, right? So take, for example, a UTM campaign. You know, we're running a Spring 23 campaign, so that could be, you know, what you name your UTM campaign. So a lot of times I see people doing things like, you know, sale or Black Friday, but not getting more specific than that. So when I go back and look at all my Black Fridays, do I know what year they came from? Do I know, you know, what quarter they came from? So, whoops, sorry about that. So you might even go a little bit further, Spring 23 Q1 or Q2 or whatever that, you know, the quarter might be. So you can get really specific with these conventions. Be precise. So when you're using multiple UTM parameters at the same time, remember to keep in mind, you know, that if you're sending out an email, the UTM medium equals email, and that will tell you that, hey, this click came from an email. The source was a newsletter, right? So that might be the type of email you're sending, whether that's a newsletter or a drip sequence or, you know, a specific email campaign. That's a really great way to utilize that UTM source. And then UTM term, it might be, you know, limited get 25% off or something like that. So depending on what the subject line is of the email, a lot of times I've seen people use the subject line of a specific email. If you have a different subject line per email, that would be a great way to use the term or the content as well. And then just be consistent. So using good naming conventions on all content from emails to organic social posts is a great way to really get the most out of your metrics and understand which marketing campaigns or emails or social posts are driving the most traffic, most revenue, et cetera. And one thing to really be aware of is link shorteners, right? So a lot of times I'll run into, get on calls with people and, you know, we're wondering, hey, how come these UTMs aren't tracking or, you know, something's not tracking right? And so a lot of times UTM shortener or URL shorteners, you know, such as like Bitly or a number of others, can have a tendency to strip off those UTMs once the page resolves. So just be really careful of that. So like, let's say, for example, we have like a short link or something. And one way to kind of look at that as well in Segmetrics and get an idea of, you know, hey, are my short links working, or any other ideas about, you know, setting up your UTMs. Here in Segmetrics, and this will show up in every account of Segmetrics, if we go to our site setup, you know, really getting ready to track the UTMs is important, right? So one thing we're going to really, really need to make sure that we do is deploy our tracking pixel. And that's another thing I see very commonly. Hey, how come my links aren't tracking? How come things aren't tracking? Well, this tracking pixel, your account is not on the website or on the landing page that you're directing the traffic to, okay? So just be really careful and be really sure that you double check that, because that is definitely a key ingredient in getting the most out of that tracking. Another way to kind of look at your setup is to view your setup instructions. So again, on the site setup page, if we click this view your setup instructions, brings us to a page that kind of gives you an overview of all the platforms you've currently integrated with. And it does usually have a section about URL shorteners, right? So if we're going to use something like Bitly, let's say this is the example shortened URL, and you'll want to test to make sure, like, let's say you put this URL. Let me go back to my tracking links really quick. So let's say I put this URL into Bitly and I said, okay, I want to shorten that up, because a lot of folks don't like the way, you know, a long link looks with a bunch of UTM parameters, because, you know, to the untrained eye or to the general populace, that might look a little spammy. I've heard that term used before. So a lot of folks like to use something like a URL shortener. So just be really careful that when you test your URL shorteners, it resolves to showing all of the UTMs on that link, okay? So this is an example. Good, when you resolve, it still has the UTMs on there, or bad, it would have stripped the UTMs, and therefore any of those UTMs will not be tracked in Segmetrics, and in turn usually won't be tracked in like your Google Analytics or, you know, any other tracking platforms. And depending on what type of email platform you're using, say for example ActiveCampaign, a lot of times like ActiveCampaign, I've seen it in Keep, I've seen it in Drip, and a number of other email services where you can actually set up automatic UTMs to be placed on every link within your email. So if you do have that feature available to you in your email platform, I would suggest utilizing that, because very similar to what we offer. It's just that then you can take that and have it automatically placed on every single link that you have in every email. So I run into people that, you know, hey, I have, you know, 200 emails that go out over this sequence. I can't go in there, you know, in good time and change every single link, right? So if that's the case for you, you might want to look into how can I utilize my email platform features and what they currently offer to me as well. Now, keep in mind, even if you don't build the tracking links in Segmetrics and you don't build your UTMs in Segmetrics, as long as the UTMs resolve on the page, we'll still pull them in through our pixel. Okay, so again, just want to make sure you understand that tracking links feature is not required in order for us to track UTMs, okay? Now, another good way to set up your UTMs as well, and I'm going to drop this doc here in the chat. I see a question that I might want to answer now from Alan. So he says, so shortener links can't be used if you put the full UTM. I think the main thing to be aware of is that once you shorten the link, right? So like, let's say, for example, let me go back here. Oh, setup instructions. Like, let's take this link, for example. Oops. All right, so now I'm gonna put that in here. Let's say I've set up a link with a bunch of UTMs on this Bitly link. And when I hit enter, you'll notice that there's no UTMs at the end here. So that's where we're going to have the bad result, where we don't track those UTMs. So every you know, link shortener platform is a little bit different. So I would just kind of, you know, look at their docs and kind of, you know, or contact their support just to make sure that, you know, everything would would resolve properly. So really what we're looking for is on the resolve that we at least have the UTM showing in the URL address bar, okay? So hope that answers that question, Alan. Let me know. Cool. So moving forward, and just FYI, in that PDF that I shared earlier, there's a lot of good stuff in there in terms of like at the bottom, you know, using UTM values in emails for social versus social posts versus third-party sites and ads, et cetera. One thing I want to be aware of as well when it comes to your tracking links feature is that we usually don't recommend them for your ads, because if you're running like a Facebook ad or a Google ad, you're going to build those links within that ad. And then keep in mind that, and we can see that on your setup instructions, if you're using like Facebook or Google ads, there's a set URL parameters box that you would place, you know, your ad UTMs, and they have very specific UTMs you'll want to use for Facebook versus Google versus Twitter versus Pinterest, et cetera. Okay, just keep that in mind. Generally, our tracking links feature works really great for emails, social posts, and kind of anything really that's not an ad, okay? Cool, so we just kind of want to move on here. So that kind of brings us to the meat and potatoes here of reporting on UTMs and Segmetrics, right? So now that we've set up and have been sending emails, deploying social posts, and people are clicking those links, we want to know, hey, how can we view those in Segmetrics and how can we get the most out of that tracking? So within your Segmetrics account, essentially what you can do is I'm just going to go to any report here, like an acquisition and new leads report. And keep in mind, you can really access these anywhere on any of these reports. So I'm kind of give you a few different examples. It just really depends on how you want to be looking at your data and the differences in terms of, like, for example, the new leads is going to show any new contact that was created in your email platform within the last X days here, okay? So, but down below is where we can kind of start seeing that information. Oh, you know what? And before I get going too far on that, I want to kind of go over this this other doc that I placed in here. So if you want to be really specific on how we categorize, you know, a channel within Segmetrics, whether it's like an email channel, which you'll notice when I, let me get rid of some of these tabs actually so I don't keep hitting them. Like, for example, you're going to see this channel and whether it's a paid, affiliate, email, display, social. So that's a way for you to specifically categorize those channels that people are coming in from. So the channel categorization doc will tell you, hey, which specific UTMs will allow you to specifically differentiate different channels where people are kind of coming in from. So email, again, is going to be, you know, UTM email, UTM medium equals email. If you want to track it as an affiliate, like let's say you have third parties running ads for you, or, you know, maybe you have a guest post on someone's website, you know, that might be the affiliate. So UTM medium equals affiliate, or if it's a referral site. So you can kind of check these out and get really specific with your channel categorization within Segmetrics as well. Okay, so, but coming back to the UTMs, you'll notice that we can kind of click on UTM campaign or UTM source and get an idea of, hey, okay, now that people are clicking our links, let's get an idea of how many leads or customers or the conversion rate or revenue is coming in directly from those campaigns, sources, terms, et cetera. So, again, we can then specify, okay, this UTM campaign here, the retargeting is bringing in the most leads, the most customers, and is essentially bringing in the most revenue for me, right? We can kind of see that from the top down, and we can kind of, you know, reorder that by customers, leads, and just to kind of get an idea of which channel, which campaigns are performing the best or maybe not performing as well as we would want them to. Same thing with source, right? So we can kind of see the breakdown of the sources as well. So Facebook, this is where, again, anything with UTM source equals X is going to show up, right? Whether that's Twitter, AdWords, Instagram, or, you know, whatever other source you're kind of looking at and specifying in those links. And to see any of the other three UTMs, we can just click this other. And down below under events, we'll see, you know, UTM medium, term, content. So if we click on medium, again, that switches that over to the mediums, content, term, etc. So now we know of the new leads that came in on this date range here, most of them came in on a CPC medium or an ebook or an email. And so that's how we can kind of start tracking that and seeing that information. Or if we want to specify a specific set of that, like let's say emails, I can then click this filter icon here. And now that filters this top line and the entire report by just that UTM medium, okay? And then we can get even more specific, right? So then we can say, okay, of that email, what are the campaigns that were involved in that, right? So now I can go back to my campaigns. Okay, well, we don't really have anything there specified. Again, this is just my demo account. But if we did, you know, we can then say, okay, of the email, there might be, you know, a specific email one or email two that we want to track on that and get more insight into that. So again, like I said, we can kind of divulge this information from a number of other reports, such as, you know, a web views report. Another common one is this web views report where people like to look at that metric in, you know, specifically. So we can say then down below, okay, of anybody who viewed a web page. Now keep in mind, this is a little bit different than our lead report, whereas our lead report was showing any new contact created in the date range. The web view report really doesn't care about when the contact was created. It's just that they viewed a page, excuse me, in this date range here. So you might see a higher number here generally, because now we're taking all contacts in our CRM into account. We just have to have a pixel fire within that date range, essentially. We have UTM campaigns, again, UTM source, so same structure down here in this table. Now we're gonna see that on a broader view because now we're taking more contacts into account there. Same thing with the conversion tab. A lot of folks want us to know, okay, of all the orders created in the date range, now keep in mind, orders report is gonna be more central to, you know, any contact that created or that purchased something within the date range. Let's see if we can get that to load here. All right, cool. So again, all we need to do is click other. Notice it's not a default selection here, but again, still available here. So now I wanna know which sources brought in the most income, right? So now I can see Facebook brought in the most income for sure. You know, versus any of these other sources that I've been specifying in my UTMs, or I want to know which campaigns brought in the most or which mediums brought in the most. So CPC was bringing in the most, affiliate, email, you know, versus all these other mediums here, right? Now let's say we want to see this on a more broad view or in a more, you know, 30,000 foot view. That's where custom dashboards can come into play. Let's say we want to build out a dashboard, and I'll just do this really quick just to kind of give you an example. So I can create a new dashboard. And I'm just going to start from scratch here. And let's say I want to see engagement and I want to see web engaged leads. And again, I can change this up to my heart's content here. So let's say I don't want to see a snapshot. I want to see it more as a table, right? So let's save that and see what that looks like. So that kind of gives me, again, the channel, but let's say I want to see UTMs. So all I need to do is come in here and I just choose my table dimension. And I can say, I want to see campaigns, UTM campaigns. And I want to see a number of different metrics here associated with those campaigns, like number of orders, revenue, maybe customers, maybe customer value. So let's see what that gets us here. And now I can see all my campaigns. I can expand that out if I have more. And now essentially I get that view that I had on the reports here. But now I can start kind of getting a little more creative here in how I view this stuff. So if I create a copy, let's say, pull that up there. And let's say now I want this one to be, instead of campaigns, I want that to be my source. So again, all I gotta do is change that dimension. And now I can see, you know, retargeting, campaigns versus sources. And again, I can make more copies of that and change that to my mediums or my contents or my terms, okay? So some really good ways to kind of like view those metrics and to track those metrics and segmentics. All right. Cool. So that kind of leaves a little bit of time left for just some Q&A. So I'd be interested to know if anybody has any questions here. So feel free to put those in the chat. Again, feel free to utilize those resources that I sent out earlier, such as the UTM marketing PDF. So again, just kind of a good way, basic way to kind of reintroduce the UTMs to yourself if you're already familiar with them or if you're brand new to them. Definitely a great way to get more familiar with them. And then again, that channel categorization doc there is a really great way to, you know, specify which channels people are coming in through your UTMs as well. Okay. And yeah, so let's open it up to the questions. Feel free to throw any questions you might have in there. Cool. Let's see. So Kristen asks, can you retroactively track traffic if you haven't posted social media with UTM before? Good question. I mean, the UTMs are really specific and really essential to that tracking. Now keep in mind, okay, so one way you might be able to do that actually is because we do usually track the referrer. Granted, you won't really get much information in terms of, you know, which specific post it might have come from or anything like that. But if your pixel was installed during that time, now keep in mind, the important part is that was your pixel, your Segmetrics pixel installed at the time of those clicks? If so, but you just don't have any UTMs on those, one way you can look at that possibly is, like let's say for example, we wanna go to, we'll just do it on the web engage leads. Web views. Because we track the refer, like facebook.com, you could possibly see that. So if we did, we just search for refer. So then we can see facebook.com as a refer, how many leads came, customer. You know, unfortunately, it's not gonna give you much more than that unless you're using some UTMs, but that could be a way to know, hey, maybe I know from a date range I was running, you know, I deployed a social post or something like that. You can go to that date range and you can possibly see that information there. Unfortunately, anything else we don't really have. Well, you know, one other way, let's see, if we did Facebook, I would filter by Facebook there. And then if we were able to see like the channel, so pay direct might associate that as, you know, somebody came directly from Facebook. But yeah, really the best way would be to know, okay, somebody came from referrer Facebook. It's kind of, I think that's the best we'd be able to see on that if we weren't using a UTM. So that's why, again, UTMs are really helpful in that respect, okay? Cool. Yeah, you're welcome, Kristen. Cool, and just FYI, we will be sending out a replay of this webinar as well, and we'll probably create a course out of this as well. Cool. I don't know, is anybody, I'd also like to know, you know, a question I have, a question just came in. And let me know, you know, maybe you're already familiar with UTMs or this is just brand new information to you. I always like to know, you know, who we're talking to and skill level of everybody out there. So Alan asks, is it true to wait 24 hours to see leads deleted? Is it true to wait 24 hours to see leads deleted or stats updated? So within Segmetrics, so generally, depending on, and one way to find that out is we do a data sync every X hours, depending on what plan you're on. So if you go to your billing page, generally you'll be able to see here, I don't think it shows it on our demo account. But yeah, so for instance, on a business account, in fact, we can tell you right now, if we go to the pricing page. So on intelligence, we're at 8-hour data sync versus on the business, you're a 6-hour data sync. Or if you're just on essentials, it's a 12-hour data sync. So yeah, generally, I mean, and you'll also notice that's why we usually have, if you go to any report, the date range is from, you know, a certain date range up to yesterday, right? It doesn't usually encompass today. So like if I did last 30 days. You'll notice it goes up to May 17th, not May 18th. Sometimes there can be a lag, and it also kind of depends on how often your CRM updates things as well, and then we pull the data directly from there. So if there wasn't something, so yeah, it can take up to 24 hours to get good results or stats within that time. So, yeah. Cool. Laura says brand new info. So awesome. Glad you're able to join. And then Khan says, can we backfill UTMs for contacts? So yes, there is actually a way. There is some specific information that we need, right? So for instance, if we have, in fact, let me pull up the doc here for you, because yeah, and I'll throw this in the chat really quick and go over it with you. Okay, so there's that doc. So essentially what we can do is map data to a contact. So for example, let's say we have some CRM contacts that we don't have. Let me get rid of some of these tabs. And maybe you have some information about them that you want to get into Segmetrics, right? That wasn't there at the time of the click. So what we can do is we can create a CSV file and say, okay, and I'll kind of go get into that in a second, but we can go to our integrations tab. And on our CRM, we can then upload historical data. And you'll see visitor logs. So visitor logs is anything like you can import, you know, page views or UTM data to your contacts. So for example, let me see. I don't think the CSV is exactly looking like what we need, but for instance, excuse me, we would need the user's email address, the full URL. So keep in mind, this isn't CSV specific for this. The date the click happened, IP addresses, not required, optional. But yeah, then you can have, you know, UTM source, UTM medium, campaign term, content. So yep, absolutely, Khan. But yeah, let me know. I know we've been in direct contact. So if you need any other information on that, feel free to reach out to me directly, Khan. Cool. Cool. All right, so we got another question. Okay, so Meg says this question might be too specific, but if I want to track our weekly article newsletter, but the specific URL changes each week since it's a new article each week, can I just set one general tracking link with our main website URL? Good question. Or do I need to change the tracking link every week? Yeah, unfortunately, if you want to get really specific, you would want to change that each week. Because for example, if it's like, you know, something like, you know, blog, well, actually, let me do this. Let's do this here. So like, let's say this is, you know, blog week one or something like that. And then you have, you know, your website. Let me just copy and paste that. Sorry, my wireless keyboard died on me, so that's why I'm reaching over and typing everything. Like blog one, right? And then next week it's blog two as that page. Yeah, you would want to essentially create a new tracking link for each one, especially if you're going to change up the UTMs on that. So yeah, you got it. Cool. Well, I'll leave one more minute or so to see if any new questions come in. But yeah, lots of great questions. So do UTMs work well in texts? Ah, yeah. So we get this question a lot because we don't actually integrate with, that's a good question, Alan. So we don't actually integrate with any specific like texting services like Twilio or anything like that. So yeah, that's where UTMs can come in really handy, right? So let's say this is text one. And you have a link going, right? That might be, you know, promo one or whatever that might be. You know, your source again could be like, if say you're using Twilio, right? Twilio could be the source. Medium could be like SMS. Oops. Oh, okay. I can't type it. Yep, and then whatever campaign. So yeah, so essentially what I would do is I would do the sources, like whatever that platform is you're using, and then medium SMS, and just as long as it'll resolve. With those UTMs showing on the webpage, we should, and the pixels deployed, we should have no problem picking that up. So yeah, totally. Cool, so just looking for any other questions. Cool. Awesome, so again, we'll be sending this replay out very shortly, within the next day or so. And then, you know, feel free to share that with your colleagues. Again, feel free to share any of the information or resources that I sent to anybody you'd like, whether that's a colleague or a client or anybody else that wants to know more about UTMs. But yeah, I want to say thanks for joining. And until next time, but if you do have any other questions and need to get in touch with us, feel free to email us directly at support@segmetrics.io. I'll throw that in the chat here as well. Yep, and that's how you can get in direct contact with us. If you have any other questions regarding UTMs or anything about your account, we're always happy to help, all right? Well, again, thanks for joining everybody, and I'm looking forward to seeing y'all on the next one. And have a great rest of your Thursday, and have a great weekend.